this inward journey for wholeness, I came to know my inner self, which is hidden in me. I came to realize that I need to trust my own inner wisdom. There are also many other things which help me to come out of myself from what I learned from that session. So now, in the future, I am going to live for something greater than myself.
As I went through this inward journey for wholeness, I discovered my inner struggles and the pretense and the mask that I was given. Now, after these sessions, I have come to know my inner struggles and I will be working upon all this. And I am now able to accept myself as I am because heaven is in me and I will cultivate all the hopeful thoughts in order to bring my life happier and to bring joy to all the people whom I will be contacting.
Attending this inward journey for wholeness, I think it is very educative and most importantly to introspect myself and see who I am to myself and to my other fellow human beings. During the session of Inward Journey for Wholeness, the topics of perception, proactive actions, the theory of Joe Harry Window, mind fixation, mind virus were not so familiar to me. Well, the good part is that since I have learned it, I will put it into practice. Last but most importantly, through the Inward Journey for Wholeness, I learned to check my inner motives before doing things, avoid negative and argumentativeness, accept love and understanding, then share it.
Before the session of the Inward Journey for Wholeness, I was a person who gives easily to my feelings of rejection and the thought I'm not capable comes to my mind. The lesson I acquired was the importance of my mind and that I can have control over my whole self, what I want to be with a positive mindset. From now on, I want to be a person who has a positive attitude, confidence in myself, and instead of avoiding the bad situation, I will say I can.
This inward journey for wholeness has pushed me to come out of myself and motivated me to get rid of my fears and to be open to feedback. Now, I am confident and ready to face them bravely.
At the very outset, I thank Dr. Sister Penny Rose Chinier for generously imparting her knowledge to each one of us. During her input sessions, dynamics, Joe Harry Window and the Onion Diagram has really given me an insight and helped me firstly to be open to feedback and to extend free areas in the hidden, blind and unknown areas of my life. Secondly, it has helped me to peel out the false layer, the blocked layer, the explosive layer and thus to become my true self that is filled with love. And so now I would like to strive to live my life to the full, making the word of Jesus to come into life. That is, I have come so that you may have life and life in its fullness.
Before the inward journey for wholeness, I was not so aware of myself. But now I have come to know myself better and how I should handle my attitudes and emotions. I also came to realize that the words I can't exist only in my mind, but not in reality. And I am now free from perception. And in future, I am looking forward to help people to know themselves better.
Through these input sessions of my inward journey to wholeness, I am enlightened and motivated in many ways, especially has helped me to come out of my fears and handle situations in a calmer way. However, there are still many things I need to discover in life, and this session is one of the means. Thank you.
Before the session, I was not aware of my behavior. My way of thinking, speaking, and acting was completely different. From the session, I came to know better knowledge of myself and got an idea how to handle over all the problems and difficulties that I will be going through. And in the future, I want to be a better person.
Before the sessions, I was a person with a strong mind fixation. But during the inward journey for wholeness, I was enlightened with little bits, which has helped me to broaden my mind, to focus not only on my negative aspects, but to look beyond my positive aspects as a journey in my life.
During this inward journey for wholeness, I came to realize that life is too short and precious to be dwelled in anger, hurt feelings, and other problems. It has helped me to free myself from all negative experiences and to discover my true self. I am really grateful to Sister Dr. Penny Rose Jr. for convincing me that I am valuable and my true self is love and compassion.
All the topics that were taken during the inward journey for wholeness are very helpful to introspect oneself. But the topic perception and mind frame really took my attention. That is the image shown to us. The image has a two beautiful picture in it, but I saw only one. And when I was told there were two, I discovered the other. Before this inward journey for wholeness, I tend to look only on one side and give the conclusion there. And this brings about many misunderstandings and as well as hurts. But now I realize that there are many ways to look at things or situations. In short, to see the total reality and not partially.
Certainly in life, there are things which disturbs me, even without my realization. But during the sessions of inward journey to wholeness, I learned that there is probably a reason for all these happenings. Perhaps a small wound deep within. But I also realized that in that deep within, there is a true self that is capable of loving and being compassionate. In order to let this true self take control of me, I need to free the hurts that is deep within. And I've done it, and I will continue to do it, and allowing myself to become the person in the mind of God.
I am Sister Amboy Hansel Vasquez Nachos, standing here to share my experience of the inner journey session that was conducted by Sister Dr. Penny Rose Jr. Yes, I would say that I was extremely fortunate to be part of the inward journey for wholeness, where I could discover more of myself all in total reality. The experience that I had was extremely great, so to say, where I could discover myself of both weakness and strength. The session that was based on various themes like perception, mind fixation, self-image, and Johari Bindo was extremely amusing and at the same time somewhat annoyed to discover my ill habits and attitudes that I've been entertaining in the past days and past years. But now, after having attended the stations, I realized that I need to know myself more and fully in order to have a healthy growth. As Socrates says, the unexamined life is not worth living. So now I can say that I can handle my situation in a better way to grow physically and spiritually.
The inward journey session has brought me to the realization of some of my weakness and hidden areas. Before the session, I was not aware of the cause of my weakness that I was going through. So, through the session and my personal reflection, it helped me to find a root cause of my anger, fear and mind fixation, of which I have been slave for many days and years. So in my future, I want to apply the methods which I learned and be a person of loving, compassionate and understanding towards others and create a healthy relationship with God and with my neighbors.
Decisions which were taken during the inward journey to self made me realize who I am, who I was, and it offered me suggestions and inputs to redeem myself from the mistakes which I have made, filled me with new informations to lead a better and a healthier life. But most importantly, it has helped me to value myself and to look at life in a more optimistic way. And I'm looking forward to the coming days to put into practice whatever I have learned and gained. Thank you.
My inward journey to wholeness. Before this session, I failed to see the reality of my problems and situations. But during the session, I realized that I need to see the totality and not partially. And I also realized that the problem is within me and not somewhere else. So, in the future, I would like to carry out these 2 points. First, to accept the reality. Second, to accept the problems willingly and to overcome them with love and compassion.
This inward journey for wholeness made me to realize before what I was. It was like staying in darkness, with full of negative thoughts, with anger, lack of confidence, fear, anxiety. And the second point is, during or at present, what I'm told to do. That is to proact instead of react, to be kind and to reason out. And the third point is that after or in future, what I'm told to do, to love and be compassionate. And by practicing love by 5 A's, that is acceptance, attention, appreciation, affection, and allowing.
Before the sessions, my mind was closed up with the negative thoughts. And during the sessions, I realized that the real problem is within me. And in the future, I will be more compassionate towards others. Thank you.
I express my sincere gratitude to you, dear Sister Penrose, for helping me to receive the grace of God flowing in me by accepting myself as I am. Before I made an inward journey, I never believed that I could change my thoughts and perceptions about myself as well as about others, especially those feelings that are in my unconscious mind. But during the session, I was made aware that the unconscious feelings are nothing, but only a collective of living and healing symbols and a hidden pearls to transform my life through God's grace. I really believe in this, and therefore, I am no longer going to blame or condemn my unconscious feelings, but I accept them. And now I feel myself more liberated and hope to become more and more liberated person through my goodwill and efforts in days to come, and thus help others in future.
Before, I was going through lots of inner struggles, which I was not aware of myself. When I made my inward journey for wholeness, I came to know my true self, and I became aware of myself through the input station self-esteem. And I realized the preciousness and the values of my being, and in my future, I will be a lovable and understanding person, and I will let others not experience the bad experience that I had experienced. Thank you.
Inward journey for wholeness. I divided into 3 categories, that is, before the session, during the session, and after the session. Before the session, I had a wrong thinking about myself, self-pitying, and easily got hurt. But during the session, it helped me to bend out all the negative thinking and to be free, and I realized my need to be changed, my attitude, my reaction, and action. And after the session, what I want to be in the future is, first, to be a person free from burden in spite of all problems. Second, I must learn to look things in different angle and not to stuck up there. Last, to let it go all the other problem and be my true self.
After knowing my own self, I would like to confront my shadow and name them so that I may not project on to the others. And I would like to continue sowing the seed of positive thoughts in my heart and the hearts of others, so that the positive result may come out in my heart and the hearts of others. For a positive thought is the result of the positive seed.
From this station, I am much aware that I am more valuable than gold and silver, and I'm proud to be me because heaven is within me. Even though my past life seems to say furiously that's never true, I will rise up and redeem myself with my Redeemer Jesus. And in the future, I will encourage the people that we are created by God in His divine love, and we are much more valuable than anything.
The loveliest masterpiece of the heart of a person is thankfulness. Dear Sister Dr. Penrose Chinyer, it would be unjust or unkind on our part if we don't rightly express our sincere and heartfelt gratitude
for all that you have been to us. We are extremely happy for sharing your time, talent, energy, knowledge, and wisdom through the session of the inward journey for wholeness during the past days. Your session has really helped us to discover ourselves and to open the hidden and unknown areas of our life to have a sound and healthy growth. We have benefited much and a lot through your station, dear sister. Thank you so much, and we also ask God's blessings upon you and in all your endeavors. May He continue to preserve you and keep you free from all harm, danger, and sicknesses, especially from this current pandemic COVID-19. And we also wish and pray that the good Lord may multiply many souls of your caliber through your generous contribution in our province and in our institute at large. Thank you, dear sister, so much for what you are to us.
And dear sisters, the best way to express once again our gratitude is to promise and assure you that we will put into practice whatever you have taught us in the past days and strive for wholeness. Now we voice out our sentiments of prayers and good wishes through this song.
Benedicat in Dominus, ego sodia Dei.
Benedicta,
Benedicta.